Well, it came to me. I created a documentary on it as well. I produced a documentary on it as well. I mean, it came to me very much as a surprise and somewhat of a phenomena. I mean, when you just say it straight out, you know, what is a brony? A brony is a 20-year-old guy who watches a cartoon intended for 10-year-old girls. You know, you get some raised eyebrows. When people started making fun of that, in this case, news programs in the United States, that's when I decided maybe it was time to do a documentary to give people who, excuse me, they happen to be watching a show which is about being good and kind and generous and honest and loyal and what have you. And if we're going to start making fun of people like that, they need some sort of help. So that's how we ended up making that documentary, or why we made the documentary. And I find it really interesting. And I also recognize them a lot from the, you know, in the same way from here at a Star Trek convention, they were sort of like Star Trek fans. So so I'm really glad that I got involved in that. I think people are turning away from religion as a source of moral, as the source of all morality. And I think that they have good reason to do that. We are seeing a lot of examples of the ill use of religion. The show provides sort of a secular moral a series of stories, you know, parables and what have you. And so I think in that way it has become popular amongst a younger generation who, for good reason, have chosen not to have certain associations with organized religion, and yet enjoy the instruction that the show provides, again, to be good and kind and you know, and loyal and what have you. So it also provides community. One of the things that I found to be really fascinating about it is that, you know, you would look at a young man who you would say, well, okay, he's not going to be the, you know, he's not going to get picked for the baseball team, like myself. Or a young girl who you're going to go, well, she's not going to be the prom queen. So where are they going to go? And you think, well, they lead perhaps quiet lives. And what I found really fascinating is that they would go up to their rooms, they would turn on their computer, they would get on Skype, and they had friends all over the world, far more than I have, all over the world, who they would talk to every night, who then, because of this show, they could talk about what the story was about. They could then, many of them very artistic, so that they're showing, you know, they're creating remixes of the music. They're animating a whole different. Some of these animations, Lauren Faust and I, Lauren would say, she said, you know, some of these animations are so well done, they're so sophisticated. These people are essentially professionals, but they're doing it as amateurs. I found all of that really fascinating, especially in light of the fact that the first reaction that you get is, you know, there are 20-year-old guys watching a cartoon for 10-year-old girls. Oh, well, we all know what that means. Well, that, if you were willing to not just look at the cover and open up the pages of that book, you found a fascinating world. And one that I support. So that's why I think, some of the reasons why I think I've touched on that the show has grown to be more than the sum of its parts. Well, of course I have a favorite pony. Me. But I know that. Well, you're not really a pony. Oh, well, I'm the favorite character, so there we go. Yeah.